Dear students, today topic function anatomy of the extremities, biomechanics of muscle and joints of the trunk and extremities. A learning objectives: introduction, basic principles of biomechanics, lever operating principle, what determines of the real effect of muscle action, muscular coordination, movement, types of muscle work, kinematic change, person center of gravity, the conspect of posture. The purpose of the lecture: to study the mechanism of human movement as well as mechanical phenomena in tissues, organs and systems. Medical biomechanical data serve as the basis for therapeutic, physical education, orthopedics and traumatology, valuable design of prosthesis, etc. Human biomechanics is an integral part of applied sciences that studies static and human movements. Biomechanical research covers various levels of organization of living matter: biological, macromolecular, cells, tissue, organs, organ system, as well as entire organism and their communicators. Human biomechanics is a comprehensive science. It includes a wide variety of knowledge of other sciences such as mechanics and mathematics, functional anatomy and physiology, age anatomy, physiology, physical culture theory. Biomechanics methods: systemic analysis and systemic synthesis of movements based on quantitative characteristics, in particular cybernetic modeling of movements. Biomechanics as an experimental empirical science is based on experimental study of movements. Using instruments, quantitative characteristics are recorded, for example, speed, trajectories, acceleration, etc., allowing you to distinguish movements, compare them with each other. Considering the characteristics, they mentally divide the system of movements into component parts. They establish if composition. This is essence of system analysis. Phenomena studied: human walking, phylogenetically ancient, well automated and cyclical locomotion. The study of walking analysis is convenient in that the entire musculoskeletal system is involved in its implementation. This allows you to investigate the function of any of its parts, including the upper limbs and spine. The main stand in the position and movement of general center of body weight when standing. Examined on a special platform, the methods of stabilometry. Static position, finite position information allows you evaluate the relative position of body segments and determine amplitude of movement, for example, the shape of the spine estimate in the three planes: frontal, sagittal, and horizontal. The development of the mechanics in the Middle Ages was significantly influenced by the research of Leonardo da Vinci on the theory of mechanism, friction, and other issues. This great artist, mathematician, mechanics, engineer, first expressed the most important idea for future biomechanics. The science of mechanics in therefore so noble and useful more than all other sciences that all living bodies with the ability of more act according to its laws. For example, muscles begin and always touching bones, and they never begin and in the same bone. Science say could not more anything except themselves. Leonardo da Vinci let the book and the principle of mechanics proceed. You studies of the body, so that you can explain every position of anatomy with geometric clarity. Leonardo da Vinci. Further from the book by De Borelli, De Motti, Animalium, Liver System, Muscle Attachment Scheme, when flexion in the joint and when unbending. The muscular skeletal pattern of two people holding different loads differently. The founder of science of biomechanics of rightful considered Giovanni Borelli, an Italian naturalist, professor of university in Messina and Pisa, in addition to works in the field of physics, astronomy, and physiology, he developed issues of anatomy and physiology from the perspective of mathematics and mechanics. He showed that the movement of limbs and body parts in humans and animals when lifting weights, walking, running, swimming can be explained by principles of mechanics. For the first time, interpreted the movement of the heart as muscle contraction, studying the mechanics of chest movement, and established the possibility of lung expansion. The most famous work of the scientist animal movement, De Motti Animalium, his teaching in the base of the solid biomechanical principles. In his work, he described the principles of muscle reduction and first presented mathematical schemes of motion. He first used biomechanical model to explain motion in biomechanical systems. A lever arm, then FD, FT, 2-point support or point rotation. FD, muscle contraction force. FT is the point of application of the opposing force of gravity. A shoulder of strength. The shoulder of force is the shortest distance from the fulcrum to the line of action of the force. LFD, shoulder of the acting force. LFT, shoulder of the opposing force. Movement of force value characterizing the rotational effect of the force, then it acts on lever M equal F multiple L V-E-Force shoulder. Lever properties, lever equilibrium condition, here in pictures you can see here, this equality is violated and the lever rotates in the direction of the force whose movement is greater. The greater the movement of force, the greater the effect of the muscles now action. Types of levers. Lever one kind, balance, two arm, points of application of forces allocated on positive sides of the fulcrum. Types of lever. Lever second kind, one shoulder points, application of force located on one side of the fulcrum. Speed lever, power lever, dexterity. Balance lever first kind, to the vertical from the now center gravity runs in front of the frontal axis of the joint. FT direction of gravity, FD direction of the resulting muscle force, LFT gravity shoulder, LFD muscle strength shoulder. And you can see here in pictures. Balance lever first kind, equilibrium, MFT equal MFD, forces are directed in one direction, flexion, MFT more to MFD, in the muscles of the neck area relax. Extension MFT to less MFD in if the traction of the muscles of the neutral region increased. You can see in the pictures also here. Power lever second kind, that is the head of the metatarsal bones. FD direction of acting force, FT direction of gravity, LFT, LFD arms, LFD now more than LFT, hence LFD more LFT, the wind is in force minus in small amplitude and in speed movements. You also can see in pictures here. Speed lever 2. That is elbow joint. FT direction of gravity. FD direction of the result muscle force. LFT, LFD force shoulders. LFD less 2 LFT, therefore MFD, MFD now less 2 MFT. Now here, gain in the run of motion, speed agility minus small acting force. Factors defining the real effect of muscles action. Physiological diameter, the sum of the cross-sectional areas of all muscle fibers that make up the muscle. Anatomical diameter, the cross-sectional area of the muscle perpendicular to its length in the widest part. Fusiform muscle diametric loads. Now here, serous muscles, static load. The strength of muscle with a cross-sectional area of 1 cm, 1 square centimeters is approximately equal to 10 kilograms. For hip flexors, about 540 kilograms. For forearm flexors, about 160 kilograms. For the chewing muscle lifting, the lower jaw 390 to 400 kilograms. The cross-sectional area of the three pairs of muscle is 39 square centimeters. In total, chewing muscle 7.5 square centimeter, temporal muscle 8 square centimeter, medial pterygoid muscle 4 square centimeters. Factors defining the real effect of muscle action: the number of motor units involved in the reduction to enable a larger number of motor units. The following conditional area required swing while the muscle is stretched, therefore more nerve fibers are irritated and more motor units are included in the contraction. The number of motor units involved in the reduction and enable a larger number of motor units, the following conditioners are required: state of nervous system attuned. Factors of defining the real effect of muscle action: the number of motor units involved in the reduction to enable a larger number of motor units, the following condition are required: state of nervous system, excessive excitement. Factors definite continuous composition of muscle fibers: one motor unit contains one type of muscle fiber. Stair dominant red muscle fiber static job. Sprinter dominant white muscle fibers dynamic job. Nine-time Olympic champion Carl Lewis had over 70% white fibers in his leg muscle. Therefore, in running for short distance, he developed a speed of 45 km/h. Factor defining the real effect of muscle action continues: the size of the shoulder or acting force, the short the arm length, the more force of must be applied for optimal torque. Factors defining the real effect of muscles: angle of muscle attachment. If the angle is right, then the force muscle traction is used to move completely. If the angle is sharp, then phi FD equal FM multiple sine. The smaller the angle, the more force must be applied, like to muscle, creating force and movement of rotation. Functional muscle groups. Functional muscle groups, here a genus one or more muscles in each functional group perform the main function. Functional muscle group. Synephestes, muscle of one joint that perform a function in one direction. Antagonistes. Antagonistes is this muscle of one joint that work in opposite directions. Here, functional muscle group. Musculus flexor carpi radialis, musculus flexor carpi ulnaris. Synergism, flexion, wrist flexion, antagonesis, adduction, and abduction hand. Division into groups is not constant, and muscles can be synergistic with one movement, and antagonistic with another movement. Here, in relation to the joint, single joint muscle. For example, single joint muscle in pictures you can see here. You can see here and here deltoid muscles. Here you can see here and brachialis muscle. Here brachial muscle. Here. And now, next now, slides, in relation to the joints, here, multi-articular muscle, here, quadriceps muscle, the femoris, and biceps muscle, so, of the now, this arm regions, and so forth, you can see also here, quadriceps muscles, here, where present foreheads and biceps muscle, you can see here, here present two heads. Inability of the muscles to perform movements due to extremely stretched antagonistes muscles. Here, passive muscle and failure. Active muscle failure. Active muscle failure, the polyarticular muscle cannot produce full movement in all joints, since the length of the muscle insufficient to hold or perform the movement. A muscular coordination of movements. Each movement involves several muscles that are synergistic, and the contraction of synergistic reflects inhibition of antagonistic occurs. Weak resistance of antagonistic muscle allows for smooth movement. The work of the multi-joint muscle ensures coordination movement with the saving of muscle energy. Type of muscle work, yielding, dynamic with negative effect. The muscles while remaining tense gradually relaxes, yielding to the action of one another resistance. Overcoming dynamic with positive effect, in which the muscle overcoming the severity of given link of the body or another resistance and perform works. Holding static, there is balancing of action resistance is result of which there is no movement. Single joint muscle cause movement in only one joint, but indirectly they induce movement in joints located distal or proximal to the joint. For example, when flexing the elbow joint, slight extension of the shoulder occurs simultaneously. Kinematic chains. Any body moves freely in space has 6 degrees of freedom: up and down, forward, backward, right and left. In the body is fixed at one point, then it cannot perform translational motion, but it can rotate about 3 axes, that is has 3 degrees of freedom. If the body is fixed at 2 points, then it has 1 degree of freedom and can rotate around one axis. Kinematic change, 3 degrees of freedom, spherical and flat joints, 2 degrees of freedom, ellipsoid and saddle joints, and 1 degree of freedom, cylindrical of block joints, because you pass here diaphysis subdivided 3 groups. You know here 1 degree freedom, here you know here cylindrical and block joint. 2 types here, ellipsoid and saddle joint, and also here condylar joint. 3 types here, multiaxial and flat plane joints here, and spherical and flat joints. Kinematic chains, all links of the support locomotor apparatus are grouped into a system of kinematic chains. The link in the chains elementary levers balance, strength, speed. There are 2 types of kinematic chains, open and close. Open kinematic chains and close kinematic chains. Open kinematic chain. This is a chain of levers, the distal link of which is free. Upper limb, a greater degree of freedom. Here, possibility of isolated movements in individual link joint of the open kinematic chain. Open kinematic chain can become close kinematic now chain in the final link of the chain gets connection with the support of capture. 3 + 1 + 1 + 1 equals 7 degrees of freedom at the hand. 3 + 1 + 1 + 2 + 3 + 1 + 1 equals 12 degrees of freedom at the fingers. A close kinematic chain, isolated movements in the joints are impossible. A change in position in one joint leads to a change position in 3 joints. When reducing at least one muscle of the now close kinematic chain, all links of the kinematic chain move here. Close kinematic joint may open. Permanently close kinematic chain. Close kinematic chain cannot open. Then human ribs Cage consists of 72 bones and cartilaginous elements, movable, connected at 104 points. Center of gravity. The geometric point of the body through which the resultant of all gravitational forces acting on the body at any position in space passes. Here, center of gravity. Center gravity of the trunk in front of the upper edge of lumbar one. Center gravity of the head, 7 millimeters posterior to the Turkish saddle. Center gravity of the hand, 1 centimeter proximally to the head of the third metacarpal bone. The open center gravity is located in the pelvic cavity, 2.5 centimeters below the promontory of the sacrum and 4-5 cm above the frontal axis of the hip joints, in the middle of the distance between the sacrum and the pubic symphysis. The location of the open central gravity is determined by 1H new bones. Newborns, the 5-6 seconds and 2 years, two years, and lumbar 1, 5 years, lumbar 3, 5 years, lumbar 3. A location of the open central gravity is determined by gender, their woman, sacral 1. Men sacral 5. The location of the open central gravity is determined by constitution, here physical development. The location of the open central gravitation is determined by body position. Separated direction of biomechanics is the biomechanics of the respiratory apparatus. It is elastic and inelastic resistance, kinematics, and the dynamics of respiratory movements, as well as other aspect of the activity of the respiratory apparatus as whole and it is part lung chest. The location of the open center gravity is determined by phases of respiration, intestinal peristalsis. Types of body balance. Support area. The area of the support surface and the space between the sustentable open center gravity below the support area if the body is unbalanced, it will return to its original position under the influence of gravity. Unstable open central gravity above the support area. If the body is unbalanced, it falls under the force of gravity. Sufficient support area. Body stability conditions. The height of the open central gravity is lower the more sustainability. The vertical from the open central gravity should fall on the support area. The close to the center the most stability. Body stability conditions, angle of the stability is the angle between the vertical from the open center of gravity and the straight line drawn from the open center of gravity to the edge of the support area. The greater the stability angle, the greater the degrees of stability. Posture. Close 3 months of life, the child forms cervical lordosis and influence the developing muscle of the neck and back while raising the head lining on the back and maintaining the posture for the certain time. By 6 months, thoracic kyphosis begin to form. The child develops the ability more from lying down position to standing position and independently maintain this pola. By 9 to 12 months, lumbar lordosis begin to form under the influence of muscles that provide vertical position of the body and limbs during standing and walking. Posture. Posture is the usual posture of naturally standing person. Keeps the head and trunk straight without active muscle tension. Posture types. According to the action of you may be seen in pictures normal, the severity of lordosis and kyphosis in uniform. Posture types, please according to the action of straightened, bent, fully expressed. Posture type. According Аксенов, here случаи, случаи large cervical lordosis, small thoracic kyphosis. And therefore, you can see here, here may be form случаи, here according Аксенов. Post types according to Аксенов, lordotic, lumbar lordosis, extremely developed. Posture types according also Аксенов, kyphotic, thoracic kyphosis is especially strong. Strongly developed. You can see in pictures here house formation here strongly in lumbar regions. Static muscle in a child develop and grow more slowly than dynamic on it, so it is more difficult for children than for adults to maintain their correct body position for a long time when standing or sitting, for example, during lessons. Now here, tying quickly, children unconsciously seek to release certain groups of muscles of the trunk from the lot to easily turns into habit and leads first to poorly posture and then weakening of the back muscles and curvature of the growing and therefore malleable spine. Here in these slides you can see homeworks consolidate the lecture materials. Literature you can use here. And today our lecture finished. Thank you for your attention.